Welcome back to M-Coding, I'm James Murphy. If you had to pick, what would you say is your most disliked dunder method in Python? Maybe dunder new and all of the metaclass glory that goes with that? Or maybe you've seen my video about plus equals and don't like the in-place methods. Or hey, nobody likes taking the time to write a wrapper, maybe that's it. Well, I've got a different choice, one that's so disliked in the Python community that if you so much as ask what it does on Stack Overflow, you will be inundated with comments telling you not to use it. What dunder is it that could possibly harbor this much hate? It's none other than dunder dell. So in this video, let's check out dunder dell, see what it's supposed to do, hone in on some of those pitfalls, and of course, see some more robust alternatives at the end. First up, how does dunder dell relate to the dell keyword? Well, there's three ways that you can use the dell keyword. You can say dell x brackets something, and that usage corresponds exactly to calling the dunder dell item method. You can call it with dell x dot something, and that corresponds exactly to the dunder dell adder method. Finally, there's just dell x, which does not call the dunder dell method. This is our first hint about why people don't like dell. Dell item and dell adder are very straightforward, nobody hates those. StirX calls dunder stir, RepperX calls dunder repper, LenX calls dunder len, but dellX does not call dunder dell. But it kind of looks like it does. If I run this example, I see the dunder dell printout. But if I comment out dellX, it still gets called. Let's throw in some print statements at the start, just before we call dell, and at the end, so we see exactly when this dunder dell is being called. We see start, then just before dell, then the dell printout, and then end. So it seems like dell is triggering dunder dell. When we comment out dunder dell, it appears that it's getting called after the end of the function. So is this like manual versus explicit garbage collection? Well, still no. If we create another variable y and assign it to x, then even if we manually delete x, we don't see the dunder dell until after the end of the function. Dunder dell is, of course, short for delete. This function is supposed to run before the object is deleted. But there's a big difference between the object itself and the name that you assign to it. Every object in Python has what's called a reference count. The reference count tells you how many things are referencing that object. Assigning a name like x to point to an object increases its reference count. If I create another name like y for the same object, that also increases the reference count. So what the dell keyword is doing here is actually just deleting the name, x. This effectively just reduces the reference count of the object by one. But we don't want to delete the object if there are still things referencing it. So dunder dell is actually supposed to be run when the object's ref count hits zero. If we didn't have the y variable, then dell x here deletes the only reference to the object, so its ref count goes to zero and it should be deleted. That's why dell sometimes calls dunder dell, but that's kind of just circumstantial. But even once you understand that dell x doesn't directly call dunder dell, there's still a lot of confusion around dunder dell. You might think that dunder dell is a great place to put cleanup code. Maybe I open up a file descriptor, and then when nobody's using it anymore, close it. The main problem with this idea is that the documentation for dunder dell explicitly states that it may just never be called. Not a great property for cleanup code. The first reason that dell may never be called is because of reference cycles. Suppose I have an x and a y. Maybe it's a tree structure, so x has some children and y is one of them. Then I include a back reference to x as the parent of y. So x's children has a reference to y, and then y has a reference back up to x. This is called a reference cycle, and when you have a reference cycle, it's impossible for either of the ref counts of x or y to hit zero. Even after this function returns and it's impossible to access x or y ever again because they were just local variables, their ref counts won't go to zero because they're still referencing each other. Furthermore, even if an object's ref count hits zero, Python explicitly states that that doesn't guarantee the object's dell is called at that time. Now, in CPython, which is the Python that 99% of you are going to be using, CPython does call dell immediately when the ref count hits zero. And for reference cycles, there's a garbage collector which periodically runs and detects these kinds of cycles. As long as the interpreter didn't flat out crash, CPython does a really good job of ensuring that the garbage collector runs and all of your object's dell methods are called. But still, the docs insist that this might not happen, so you can't really depend on it. Oh, and by the way, since the time that a dell is called isn't guaranteed, it's basically impossible for you to be able to handle any errors that might propagate out of them. Therefore, the interpreter just completely ignores exceptions raised in a dell method. it'll still print the trace back, but as you can see, it still ran the code afterwards. Oh yeah, and remember, if dell is called at all, it might be called while the interpreter is shutting down. This dell tries to dump some state into a JSON file. Remember, exceptions get ignored if anything goes wrong trying to open this file. And then if Python happens to wait until the interpreter is shutting down to call this dell, then this JSON module, which is a global variable, may have already been deleted. In CPython, in practice, using even a relatively oldish version like 3.7, I haven't actually run into this issue. But once again, the documentation won't make any promises and says you need to watch out for this. What else could there possibly be that's more confusing about dell? With all the lack of promises about even basic functionality, you wouldn't think dell would support that many features. But it actually purposefully supports the idea of so-called resurrecting an object that's about to be deleted. Let's say this dell method is called because there are no more outside accessible references to the self variable. Well, we can just put self into a global variable, thereby increasing its reference count back up to 1. Of course, it's kind of your own fault if you do something like this. But Python guarantees you are allowed to do this. If you increase the ref count of an object inside dell, then its memory won't be reclaimed by the garbage collector. It will survive until another day. But you know they're not letting you get away without throwing another curveball in there, right? If an object is resurrected, then when it dies again, its dell method may be called, or it might not be called. So you also need to make sure that your dell doesn't do anything nasty if it gets called twice. I already mentioned that exceptions from dell get ignored, right? Okay, so how about we just get to an example where it does something useful and it should theoretically be okay to use. This class makes a temporary directory. When you create an instance, it creates an actual temp file. You can manually call remove on it, or the file is removed when it's garbage collected. Notice that the first time we call remove, it sets name to none. This means that if remove is called multiple times, either by the user or by dell being called multiple times, nothing will happen after the first time. We're definitely depending here on CPython's unadvertised property that garbage collection will happen before shutdown, and it will happen early enough in shutdown that this module shell util will still exist. I'm definitely not confident given all those restrictions, but it does seem to work with the current version of Python that I'm using. So if dell is so finicky, it might never get called, it might get called twice, it ignores exceptions, globals might no longer exist, how am I supposed to reliably clean up the resources used in my code? The most robust solution is to use a with statement. Define, enter, and exit methods and make sure that you call your cleanup code in the exit method. Then you can use the class like this. We just say with, we create a new instance as d, do whatever we need to do inside the with block. Then when the with block is over, Python guarantees that the remove method is called. The behavior of the with statement is much more precisely defined and you can depend on it. This is slightly limiting though. We have to use the with statement. What if I don't know when I want to delete my temp file? Maybe I'm making a text editor and I want to delete this temp file whenever the user is not looking at it anymore. That might not be confinable to a with block, but certainly if Python has no more references to the object, then it's fine to delete. If you really want to support cases where you can't use a with statement, there is another alternative. Let's leave our enter and exit method. We still want to encourage people to do it the right way. Go ahead and delete the dunder dell. Then use the weakref module to create a finalizer for our object. We can manually call the finalizer in our remove method. It's even fine to call it multiple times. We can also check if a finalizer has already run by checking its alive property. A finalizer does have some of the same pitfalls as dell. In particular, they have the same exception ignoring behavior. However, Python makes much stronger guarantees that finalizers will run and when they'll run. In particular, when the interpreter shuts down, all remaining finalizers that are still alive and haven't been disabled will be called, and they'll be called in the reverse order that they were created in. It's also guaranteed that these finalizers will run early in the shutdown process before any global variables like modules have been deleted. And of course, by design, finalizers are allowed to be called multiple times and their effects will only happen the first time they're called. This makes them a more robust and dependable solution compared to dell when you can't use a with statement. I didn't really say much about what weak references are. Normal references, like assigning the name x to a variable, increase the reference count. Those are called strong references and they would keep the object from being garbage collected. But we obviously don't want the finalizer of our object to keep it from being garbage collected. Its whole purpose is to run right before the object is garbage collected. So it's actually possible to create so-called weak references that don't increase the reference count and don't prevent it from being garbage collected. If you want to hear more about them, make sure to leave a comment. That's all I've got. See you in the next one, and don't forget to slap that like button an odd number of times.